to Robison Hall at the Mahaney Arts Center. A reminder to turn off your cell phone, even if you think you've already done so. As a courtesy to the performers and to the audience around you, please, no texting during the event. Please note the location of the emergency exits, at the back of the hall, where you came in, and on both sides of the stage. Thank you for keeping your mask on for the duration of the event. Enjoy the performance.
Good afternoon, and thank you so much for joining us on a lovely May day for what is the first public concert that this chorus has had in a year and a half, since the fall of 2019. So our presence together on stage, all of us together, is an event unto itself and a consummate joy, and we're so glad for you to share it with us. The program began with Brahms' phenomenal and well-known movement from the Requiem, Deutsches Requiem, and the text speaks of nature and speaks of home, speaks of ourselves and who we are, and who we are together. The next piece is, I think, a similar tone, and it is by singer-songwriter Connie Kaldor from Canada. And we'll follow that piece with our string quartet playing some Canadian music as well, a Canadian traditional, and a song that is a piece that's by a Vermont musician, gone Canadian, if I remember, yes. And so, Connie Kaldor's piece was arranged by Willy Zwozdecki, who is a fairly famous choral person in Canada. It's a marvelous sound that he's cultivated out of this lovely song. And in what other song do you get to sing the words, "And when the sun goes down, we'll throw our arms around each other"? It's marvelous. So I hope through our masks, you can hear us articulate that special sentiment throughout this piece in Wood River.
Thank you.
So, you may think that, you may appear that we're all one band here, strings, piano, and chorus alike. We are very grateful for you four to be joining us for this concert. As far as I know, you don't have a name as a quartet unto yourselves. But I do want to point out, in terms of names, we have one substitution, as it were. Ben Lively is playing viola. Ben Lively, class of 1999, Middlebury class of 1999. Thank you for being here. And furthermore, thank you to all four of you for playing with us on sort of this music and sharing with us your own. Now, I have the privilege to announce or to introduce Ryan Opiela-Young, a class of 2022, our student conductor. Ryan has been working with me with Community Chorus all year with the chorus, and I'm both enthralled and excited to have a student who can do what I do. It's great. So, welcome, Ryan. There always something sings.
Thank you.
So, as I mentioned earlier, the program began with a piece, the English text of which is, "How lovely is thy dwelling place." This program takes us to different places. If there is a unifying feature, it is that. And this next place is one of present suffering. A little bit about the music we're about to sing, as my concert attire shares. Ukraine is a place for which I have a personal connection. My wife and I have spent visited a few times and lived there for a few months. At one point, I taught at the University of Arts in Kharkiv. And the sharing of the music is something that we do to share our joy and our celebration of Ukrainian culture at a time when there are those who would like, not for the first time, to erase that culture. We can think of that in terms of Ukraine, and we can also think of that, we can transfer that awareness to other places in the world. Whenever an oppressor decides to take over with the intent of erasing a people's culture. Dmitri Gortnyansky is a Beethoven era, so late 18th, early 19th century composer. And this music, written for the Orthodox Church, is at its time really pan-Slavic. It's not decidedly Russian or decidedly Ukrainian. But Gortnyansky was born in Ukraine, and he was one of a lineage of composers who deliberately used Ukrainian poetry and language in their artistic works, so in their choral works, in their operatic works, and in songs, their song compositions, deliberately to preserve Ukrainian language, not simply the sort of, as I described, the pan-Slavic, or a Russian a cultural image, even though they may have worked in Russia. So that is the reason for Bortnyansky's presence, aside from the piece being simply beautiful and rewarding to sing. The second piece, Oitam Zalisochkum, is a piece that was shared with me during my teaching in Kharkiv by my colleague at the university there, Sergei Prokopov. He gave this piece to me as something I might share with choirs here, and so we do that for you. The text has a line in which, in response to the gossip that this couple experiences, they get together anyway. And it's explained to me that that's not only a gesture of a defiance against those gossips, but it is a larger statement of defiance in that their identity will persevere. And I think that that situates that piece particularly poignantly in this program.
Thank you.
I gave them the chairs. Thank you once again for coming and joining us. This is a monumental thing for us. We've been working and looking forward to this for a long time. And as has become sort of poignant for me this spring, we get to the last piece in our concert, and we kind of feel like emotionally doing it all again, because it's the last piece. So I'll take a moment for a couple of things. Judy Albright, are you here? Where are you? Where? No. Okay. I wanted to just call your attention to the artwork on the program, and if you've seen a poster in the community, the cover. I mean, you look at it at home if you want, but that's Judy Albright, and we're most grateful for her talent and donating that art for us this spring. I want to thank all of you string players for being here with us. This is a real privilege. I also wish to thank my colleague Tim Guiles for your leadership this spring. The chorus wouldn't be here without him, and your collegiality, support, and beautiful playing and artistry has been a grace to us all. So thank you. Good. I also believe that Tim has an announcement to make.
I'm allowed to talk. So I gotta say, a community chorus is a tremendously special thing. A group of people. It takes a director to lead us, and we're grateful that Jeff Buettner has taken over from Jeff Raybuck. And we have sopranos and basses and tenors and altos. You gotta give the altos a hard time. And someone who really holds us all together is our chorus manager. And I gotta tell you, it's really hard to sneak something into rehearsal without the chorus manager. But I managed to bring in some flowers.
Piece. I also have a personal thanks to Jeff Raybuck for his years and years of leadership with this ensemble. We all owe him a debt of musicianship, kindness, and friendship. So here we go. We're going to sing Marques Garrett's Rise, Shine. It's a spiritual that's arranged by these two fellows, and it's a bit of a rouser. It's a bit of a rouser if you need to rise and shine. Maybe when we're done singing, but I'm not gonna inhibit. Anything that happens at a choir concert is in the interest of energy and excitement is a good thing. So rise, shine.